This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is video 3, graphing a tangent function. We're going to graph this function, y equals negative tangent of pi x over 6. We're going to state the period and the vertical asymptotes. Now, keep in mind the vertical asymptotes are always x equals something. Okay, keep that in mind. All right, so how do you get the period? Well, the coefficient of x is pi over 6. And so remember that for the tangent function, we've got pi for the period. So you have to divide by b. In this case, b is pi over 6. So that would give us pi times 6 over pi. The pi's will cancel, or divide out. Ah, we have a period of 6. Okay, don't get thrown off by that. It's just a number line, a regular number line with x, no pi's on it. It's just 6 total. So what's that going to look like on your graph? If it's got a period of 6. Remember, the tangent of 0 is 0. We're going to have that point in the middle, 0, 0. That means the asymptotes are going to be half of that way to the right and half of that way to the left. So if this is 3 and this is negative 3, we have a full period of 6. So that's where our asymptotes are going to go. Now normally, the tangent function looks like this, right? Starts down and goes up. But notice I have a negative sign here. So everything's going to be flipped a little. Now you may think you have to put like in a little mark for 1 and 2, etc., but you don't. You could just say halfway in between, and we all know what that means. That means that's 1.5, right? So at 1.5, actually, usually you would start down here and go up, right? Since it's flipped, everything's going to go the opposite direction because you're going to multiply whatever you would normally have right here would be down at 1, but you're going to multiply by that negative sign or negative 1. So what that means is that point will be up here. So in other words, if you put in negative 1.5 for x and computed this, you would be taking the tangent of something, and you're going to get negative 1, and then you're going to have a negative times negative 1. I'm not going to do the computations. I'm just going to think of that as flipped. Sorry. And the other one's going to be down here. So that is what this function's going to look like. It's going to start up and go down instead of starting down and go up. And so there we have it. That's our basic graph. What are the asymptotes? Well, remember those are the vertical lines, x equals. All right, you just pick one of them. Doesn't matter which one you pick. You can either pick 3 or negative 3. I'm going to pick 3. And then after a full period, you get another asymptote, right? So you add, now, a full period is 6. So 6k, where k is the element of the integers. Okay, that's the end of that problem, but here, let's write it down one more time. We're graphing this. The period is 6. And just notice, if you have a minus sign in front, you're going to flip. I don't know why this does this when I touch it. So here were our asymptotes at 3. Just a little bit bigger graph. Instead of starting down, we're just starting up and going down. So a little bit bigger. And if you're going to do another period, notice the vertical asymptotes would be like 3 plus 6 times 1. That would be 9. And this is actually 9 over here, right? Because it's like for every 2 markings, I'm actually going 3 units, right? Like that's 3, 6, 9. Here we are. So if you wanted to see another period of it, That's what happens. So the minus sign means it starts up on the left and goes down. That's the basic difference. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.